If you want to learn today about AWS Lambda, how you can code your first AWS Lambda function and how you can make it run automatically, you are in the right place. So stay tuned, we are about to start, and feel free to follow for more amazing tutorial. So welcome again. Before we're going to basically do like hands-on experience, I'm going to show you the architecture of what we're going to build today. As you can see from the video, it's very simple. We're going to create AWS Lambda function that will send a Slack message, okay, in Python. You can do whatever you want then if you want, like on your own time, but this is what we're gonna do. And this function will be triggered every minute by AWS eventBridge, okay? If you don't have a AWS account, you can watch my YouTube channel about how to create your free AWS account and also how you can launch your first EC2 instance. Very simple, very straightforward. And basically, you also need a Slack account, but if you don't have, it's okay. Just follow what I'm doing, and then you can do whatever you want. Okay, so we're going to start with AWS Lambda function. We're going to go to the dashboard and pick that. This is how it looks like. Okay, and now we're basically going to press the button create function. And here you have a few options. You can create a AWS Lambda function from scratch. You can use a blueprint, someone that already creates something for you that you can pick it up and basically use it and learn from it, okay? And there is more option. As you can see, there is a lot of example. Another option is to use a container image if you guys already have. And the last option is also to use like an app that's already built and deployed, and you just click, choose, and that's it. But today I'm gonna start with a tutorial for beginner. And we're going to start something from scratch, okay? So we're going to choose this option. We're going to name our first Lambda function, my first Lambda function, okay? Very simple, as you can see. And for the environment, for the runtime, you can choose whatever you want. As you can see, the example we have here. We have Node.js, we have Python, we have .NET. I'm going to choose Python. And the next thing, usually when you want to do more than just send post message, you need more permission, but at the moment we don't need something crazy because we're just sending a post a request to Slack. So we're gonna choose the default one that is gonna create for us, the create new rule, and we're gonna create the function. It's gonna take a few seconds. Okay, so this is what happened when you pressing the create function. This is the dashboard. This is how it looks like. This is basically the first layer that we're gonna create, the first AWS Lambda function layer. As you can see, we can delete everything. We can add a trigger in order to invoke the AWS Lambda function. I'm gonna show you soon how to do it. And we can also add destination. Destination means what will happen after the function will run. Okay, today I'm just gonna show you how to trigger the function, and later on I'm going to show you in a different video how you can also do the destination. And we can also monitor our function. We can see like how many times it has been invoked. We can go on to configuration and see the other setting that we have. Okay, you can explore it later. It's not that important right now because everything is doing automatically for you. You just can go over and see how it's connected, but really don't worry about it. It's very simple, and I'm gonna show you like how simple it is by just running a specific code. So we're gonna delete the code that come with the runtime of Python, and we're gonna copy one from my GitHub. You can all go to my GitHub and copy the code that we're gonna run today. Okay, it's a Lambda function code to send Slack messages. I'm just gonna copy, paste, and I'm gonna go over to show you what exactly this code doing. So as you can see, AWS Lambda function basically build on file, like the way that you have your own application. And we can also create other files and connect it together to AWS Lambda function. But at the moment, as I said, it's gonna be very, very simple tutorial. So we're gonna load the URL request, URL JSON decoding also. And then we're gonna create HTTP instance. And this is the function that every runtime Python Lambda come with Lambda handler. Okay, this is where we're going to define the URL of the Slack messages. Okay, and the event is basically the part that you can use in order to send value or variable from the outside, from the trigger. Okay, it can be API gateway, it can be event bus, it can be other thing. I'm going to show you very soon. So after we defining the URL and the messages, we basically encoding the JSON to make it JSON request, and then we're making the HTTP request, we're getting the response, and we're printing it to the logo. Okay, it's a very simple function, not something crazy, and basically we're gonna use Slack. So in order to use Slack incoming webhook, I'm gonna show you exactly what you need to do in order to send the message to a Slack channel. So you're gonna choose incoming webhook. Okay, just press configuration and add incoming webhook to Slack in order for us to use the Lambda function to send the message to Slack. We're going to choose the channel that is already created before. It's called webhook. Okay, and basically what this app giving us, it's giving us a webhook URL. Okay, it's telling us how exactly we need to create the request. As you can see, it's a JSON request. Okay, we choose the channel before the webhook. We copy again the webhook URL. You can change the username from here, from Slack, and you can also send a username from Python, from the code, from the Lambda code. And you can also play with the icon. I'm gonna choose the robot, okay, or bot. And that's it. You're saving the sending, and you have an incoming webhook on Slack. It's very useful if you're working with Slack and you wanna send like messages in order to get updated and get notification. Okay, here is very tutorial. It's a beginner tutorial. So it's very, very simple. So you will understand how you can do it by yourself and use this amazing tool, AWS Lambda function. So after we basically define the function, now we're gonna create a test. Okay, it's very important in order to check that you're actually the AWS Lambda function is working properly, even before we invoking it with a trigger. Okay, so here we're creating a basic hello world template. Okay, and we're gonna copy and paste all the event value that we need to inject to the Lambda code. Okay, so the first one is Slack messages, Slack webhook, and then the channel. We're using the webhook channel, so we're just gonna set the webhook. Okay, so we have Slack webhook, we have the channel, and then we're gonna have the username. This is how you can control the message that you're sending to Slack. Okay, let's do AWS Lambda function. And you don't have to create the tests in AWS Lambda function, but it's very important to test your function before you actually deploy the code and run it in production. Okay, it's giving you a fast checkout to see that everything working properly and you're getting the result that you want. And now we're gonna define the message, the last value from the event that we're gonna send. Okay, let's save it. Perfect, so we have the test, everything cool. And basically this is where the values we just defined in the test will be injected. And there is this comment section that you can basically take out of comment, and it's like ready for you for API gateway request that you can also do. I just put it for you as a comment if you want to practice later. I'm not going to use it now. Okay, I make a YouTube video about how to invoke AWS Lambda function with API gateway. It's very interesting and create your basically AI. Watch it later. Okay, and now we're gonna run deploy. So actually it's mean that we're saving what we did. And let's run the test and see that everything okay. Okay, it seems like we have a typing error. Yeah, it's failed as you can see, and we have like a typing error. Let's fix it. It's even tell you the line 15. Yeah, we have like typing error. Okay, let's fix it. And let's test again our first function that we created in AWS Lambda. Okay, let's run test. And perfect, it worked. We got a success. And you can see the log that we're printing. Okay, it's a 200, okay. This is the log that we're printing. And let's go now to Slack and let's see on the webhook channel. Yeah, hello world. Congratulations, guys. You created your first Lambda function and sent Slack messages. How cool it is, how simple it is without sending any, without launching any C2 server, okay? Now we're gonna create a trigger that will send the message every 1 minute. Okay, it will invoke our AWS Lambda function and send the messages every 1 minute. You can use different trigger. This is just for the tutorial. Okay, I'm gonna show you other trigger that you can use. Okay, just for this specific tutorial, there is so many other trigger that you can do. As you can see, you have API gateway, you have AWS IoT, you have a load balancer, CloudWatch log, a Cognito, so many options. And even a different AWS partner that can invoke AWS Lambda. So as you can see, this feature, it's very demand right now because it's basically very flexible and you can use it with everything almost. So let's create our first eventBridge cron task. Okay, that will run. We will run it by schedule. You can use it to run once a day or once a month, once a week with a cron, or you can make it run like every 1 minute. Okay, this is what we're gonna use today because I want to show you the result very, very fast. Okay, we're gonna invoke. This is where we're attaching the trigger to the Lambda function. Choosing the Lambda function, and as you can see, there is other option with the event bridge. You can check later also. Okay, now we connect both of them, and the next thing we basically need to define the input that we want to send to the Lambda function by the event value, as I show you. Okay, basically those values that we defined. Okay, you can make it very dynamic. You can put different Slack channel, different messages. It depends on you. It's very simple. And really, you're gonna love it once I realize that I'm a backend developer, full stack developer. Also, and I didn't know the power of AWS Lambda. And I'm telling you guys, it's amazing. You can launch your own system very fast, very simple. I just love it. Okay, so we copy paste basically the input, the JSON input, and we save. Let's review. So basically, we created a cron task that will trigger our Lambda function that will send Slack message every minute. Okay, as you can see, it's already sent our first messages. And if you like it, please leave a comment, share, subscribe, because it's so cool. Now I'm just want to show you again after 1 minute it's actually sending another message. Okay, and while we're waiting the 1 minute, let's go over, let's see the for example monitor. As you can see, already our function is invoking and it's running. You can monitor it and see like what's going on, what's working, how many times it didn't work. You can also monitor the logs of the function. It's very cool, very easy. And as you can see, we got another Slack message automatically every 1 minute. That is all for today. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe for more amazing tutorial. And leave comment below if you have any question regarding AWS, AI, serverless, and if you want to learn more about AWS. Thank you and have a great day.